Hello, Blitz fans of all ages. It's me, PlumCastle, here showing you guys how to get more Ace Tanker badges. Whether that be if you're just trying to get better at the game, or in my case, if there is some sort of event going on where you're trying to get Ace Tanker badges. For example, like with this Ace Clan Challenge. So, first of all, this will be showing you what exactly it means to get an ace and how you can go about doing it. And if it's an event like this, be sure to check and make sure you know what tiers and what nations it's for. So first of all, how to get an ace. Well, if we go into our rewards here, if we click on ace, prove it. It's very simple. Just prove your mastery in controlling a tank. Earn more XP in a battle than the average highest XP of 99% of players who have fought in that specific tank for the last 7 days. So what that means is basically get more XP than 99% of people. So very hard, obviously. However, it can be done. So first of all, getting aces is a lot easier in a lower win rate tank or lower skill tank. So let's move on over to my other machine so I can show you how to search for lower win rate tanks. So if you go to https://blitzstars.com, you will actually be able to see a list of how different tanks perform, both in win rate, damage, etc. So it's really easy. You just go to Blitz Stars, like I said there, and in the top bar here, you'll see a few different options. In the Tanks tab, you can see here, if I click on that, it'll take me to a list of all the different tanks in the game, and as well their stats too. Just as soon as it loads, it's running a little bit slowly at the moment, but you can see there it's starting to load, and these give you, it gives you all the tanks as well. It gives you their battles, how many people play them, and wow, I had no clue that many people played the Kenyatsu. But damage ratio, damage per battle, all those nice things, including credit coefficient, which is pretty cool. So when trying to get aces, you typically want to go with tanks that have a lower win rate overall, because that means when you do win in them, you're already doing better than average. So to find out which ones are the lowest, you can see I have my mouse here over this win rate button. For me, it's highlighted. I don't know if it will be for you. Probably depends on which one you clicked last. Yeah, but if you go to the win rate, and then if you see anything like 60 on the top, you know that's going from best to worst. So if you click that again, it'll then show you something in the 40s. So you can see here, Panther 2 has the worst win rate right now. And it has 10,000 players. You can see different stats here, like the damage per battle is only 973. That's not very good. And it says here at the top, from players with overall win rates between 45 to 55. So this is the majority of players pulling off 45% in here, which is not terribly great, which is actually good because that means it's easier to ace. Now, you're probably, if you're getting aces for skill purposes, you're probably going into that tier 8 range about. However, if it's for an event and there's like no restrictions, you just have to get ace tankers, you can literally set this to anything. Like, for example, let's say we wanted to ace a tier 5. I could then select tier 5. Actually, I should clear first because that can mess up your results sometimes. You just click on the tier 5, so then you can see, okay, the lowest win rate tier 5 is the Panzer SFL IVC, which is not one that I knew of that was that low, but there you can see there's its win rate. Now, let's say, for example, like currently, there is a restriction. You have to get an ace in a tier 8 to 10 tank, or any event, really. You can apply these filters so that you can see only the tanks that will be viable for the event. So, for example, we just have to get tier 8 to tier 10. Doesn't matter what nation it's in, and we can see that the Panther 2 remains with the lowest win rate. Of course, the if we had the caveat of it needing to be American, we could see that the Perishing. So that's how you see what a low win rate is, and as well low damage per battle, because if you're getting more damage, you're going to do better. So with that, let's move over into some gameplay so you can actually see what getting an ace can look like. So for this example on what it looks like to get an ace, I was playing my VK100. Now, please do not be fooled by the tank I'm driving. The VK100 is not an easy tank to ace. it's just the one that I happened to get the ace in the soonest, so I went ahead and showed you this. So, obviously, you need to get more XP, and so while I'm moving into position, I will explain how you can get more XP. For example, first off, doing damage. The more damage you do, obviously, the more XP you get. Also, higher tier, but of course, it doesn't matter because that tier is, of course, going to have its XP amount that you need to break in order to get the most damage. So, spotting is another good one. Heavies, it's a little bit harder to spot, obviously. Really wanted that shot to go in, but it didn't quite. So, get damage, try to spot if you can, and live. I know that might sound like a no-brainer, but do try to live, but not only try to live, but be very active in the game. I find like being crazy almost seems to result in more aces, but don't take that for 100%. So let's talk more in depth about the getting damage part. Now I have an entire video dedicated to how to get more damage. If you want to check that out, I will leave a link in the description as well, a card in the upper right hand corner. However, I will still talk a little bit about it here. So first off, when it comes to getting damage, like you saw in this game, you want to start getting damage as quickly as possible. This is especially true for light tanks. Heavier tanks that take longer to get into position, obviously, it's a little bit harder, but it can be done. Also, save your hit points in the beginning. You can see here, I am going out in front of them a little bit, but I'm not being so hasty as to totally get all my hit points ripped right off of me. Also, know your tank. You can... For example, here you can see I'm using my... How that missed. I'm using my armor because I've played this tank in many, many battles, and I've gotten a feeling for it. So play, obviously, the lower win rate tanks, and also see if maybe there's a tank, of course, of the correct tier that you want to be playing, where you can get more aces. For example, in my VK28, I've have 7 aces, and yeah, sure, it's been in 1,000 battles, but still, I'm familiar with that tank, so I can get more aces in it, and I just generally perform better. However, in my case, this was for an event, so I had to be playing tier 8, so I went ahead and pulled out my old VK100. But also, I am grinding up for the Panther that I mentioned earlier, because that should be able, in theory, to give me more aces. So, you can see here, this is not looking very good, and you can see I'm still... I've not lost a whole lot of hit points yet. I have bounced quite a bit of damage due to the tank I'm in, but I still have not lost too many hit points. And you can see there's that Progetto over there. And basically, try not to overexpose. I was okay pulling out here because I wanted to get that shot, which didn't really want to do what it was supposed to. But try not to overexpose yourself, especially a late game like this where it's not looking very good. You can see here, I'm almost full health, but they've got two... almost full health tanks as well, a third, and I've only got a tier 7 with a little bit of help on my team at the moment. So you can see here, at this point, late game, especially when you think it's going to be a loss, again with that damage, try to squeeze out as much damage as you possibly can late game. And you can see here, this is going to be very tough. I find I get most of my aces in close games, which makes sense. That's games where you barely pull off a win, but I just find that getting damage is key. Spotting is, I guess, a little bit key. But I find that close games specifically, so farming as much damage as you can and getting it close somehow, if you can somehow manage to do that on purpose, tends to secure me the ace. So again, there are a million different ways to get XP. You can see I'm still on a very, very healthy amount of hit points here. And I'm just trying not to overexpose myself. Basically, you try to carry. And so you can see there's the bulldog. Poor bulldog. I can see by his camo, he probably knew what he was doing. Might have lagged out or something, and he hit the wall, unfortunately. But you can see here, I have been very careful with where I've been driving here. I've not been going everywhere. You can see here, I actually purposely did that. I was willing to lose a few hit points to block his path there. So obviously, there is some skill involved, so the better you get and the better of a tank you are in, the easier it will be. However, I know, even for me personally, it can be very hard to just go get an ace. I mean, it's one of the hardest things to just go and do in the game. So you can see here, I had a 3x multiplier on that game, so divide that by 3, I want to say I got about 1,200 XP base. And that is base XP, I forgot to mention. You cannot have these multipliers or boosters count. For example, if you have a booster and you see you get 10,000 XP, you're like, great, I just aced the tank. No, you only ace it if you get the record base XP, which means no additives. It's just the amount of XP you got, which if you want to see that, you can go over into the team section. And right here, you can see where I'm clicking here. That shows you the XP. So if you look, I got 1,203 and I aced the tank. So obviously, the more XP you get, the more likely it's going to be. So apparently, the VK's cap whenever I play this was like 1,000 something, but try to do as much as you can without sacrificing. Try to do as much as you can without overextending, sacrificing too much. Just try to be steady, actually, is what I would say. I like to try to be as calm and steady as I can. I'm like terrible at this, but if you're careful and you just try not to overextend, it'll be much easier, and obviously the more damage you get, the more spots you get, the more damage bounced you get, the more assistant damage. I know the list goes on and on, but you can do it with enough practice, and like I said, do be driving those lower win rate or lower skill tanks, because that's what people are likely not going to be doing very well in. For example, I'm not going to go too in-depth here, but another good one might be the AMX 1390. I did not check the win rate, but I do know I myself flop in this tank so bad. It's so bad, but if you get a good game, you can possibly get the ace, of course, but you might have an easier time due to the fact that people don't play very well in it. This is actually true for a lot of the French lights, so if you don't have a Panther, check Blitzstars first. But if it's got a low win rate, you might want to check out some of the AMX line. For example, my AMX ELC, wherever it may be, has a lot of aces on it. Again, you can see the AMX 12T is probably going to be another easier one. However, in this case, like I said, it's for a tier 8 and above. So do keep in mind what tier you're trying to ace and find the tank that's best suited. For example, you can see here is my AMX. I go to my tank. It's got 6 aces and only 471 battles, which is pretty decent, and I think that's just due to the fact that people don't play it very well. So, there you go. I hope y'all enjoyed. I hope y'all learned something, and if you want to see something specific, be sure to leave down in the comments what you'd like to see me make next. So, with that, I hope y'all enjoyed, and as always, have fun, good luck, and happy tanking.